Hi everybody, this is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat, and I'm here today with a walkthrough of my wedding mini for my girlfriend. She commissioned it from me, and I use Stamperia's Romantic Collection. Oh my goodness, I just love these papers. The only front cover I had left was this one, and it's kind of cut up, but I have videos on the showing the paper line. I happened to buy mine. Where's my little cheat sheet? Oh, here. I happen to buy mine from Only One Life Creations because they are an online store, but they live right here in Southwest Washington, just 10 minutes from my house. So it's great when I buy from them because I can just go to their warehouse and pick stuff up. But I always like to promote people that I've met and I know have a good business, and their prices seem to be very competitive or better than others. So I'll put their link down below. You can check them out and see what you think for yourself. I wanted to tell you also, I have another video coming because I took out four of these, two out of the 12 by 12s and two out of the 8 by 8s. And I think I told you this when I did the walkthrough way back when. Is this, remember, this is the 8 by 8, this is the 12 by 12. It was in this paper that had the nine little squares in it. But I wanted these for sympathy cards. So I will be back with another video. Just a little sneaky peeky here. Another video showing how I made those into sympathy cards. And maybe I'll find that some of these others work too, because I think I have some of the 12 by 12s of this left. I don't have a whole lot of paper, but I have enough for cards, tags, that kind of stuff. And I'll show you what I did with all the scraps. That was really funny. Okay, so I have this. And my book is the postbound book. This is a style that I got from Claire Charvel at My Creative Spirit. This is her design, and I love it, love it, love it. Claire folded her tabs inward and used post like this, the metal post, to go through it. Well, I tried it that way, and I didn't care for it, and I wanted the full impact of the page, so I left mine flat so the spine actually extends beyond the album, and I ran some book binding through it, and I also used spacers. So what I did was I took two pieces of chipboard and glued them together, and then I covered them, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, that's these, here, 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 and here. Because when you do your pages and you just have a thin sheet of paper like this, this is a page I didn't use. Let me see if I can get it in frame. So this would be my spine, and this is where I would build my page. Well, that's super thin. Then when you build up on your page, it's real cattywampus. Your spine is like this tiny, and then your book, once they get pictures in it, is even bigger. So I decided to use the chipboard spacers, and I like how it looks. It's still not quite the same depth as this one. I could put another spacer in if I want, but I think it's much better this way. That's just a little hint for you if you want to make one yourself. Now, the pages are 10 by 8.5 approximately. I have a few pictures of the couple, and their grandma says this is okay, so I'm going to go by her, what she says, but I know them, and I'm sure it's going to be okay with them too. So in the front, I put a picture of them. They got married at the Pacific Coast, but I left an opening here so that they could actually take this photo out. I need tweezers if I'm going to get it out. They could take this one out like this. And then if they have another picture they would rather have here, they can put it in. This is items from the paper line that I cut out. Now, this frame came and I just cut the middle of it out. And these two flowers, Wonderful and the Stopwatch, were right there. I added a couple extra flowers, the Stopwatch, a gem on it, and then the Forever with the cheesecloth and the linen behind it. I love this look because Grandma said they don't want too frou-frou. They don't want lots of flowers and ribbons and all this kind of stuff. So I thought that the Stamperia paper really lent itself to this. Now, Grandma really wanted this picture because this is where they live. This is an old Victorian apartment, or it was a Victorian house that was his grandfather's, I believe. And it's in Portland, Oregon. And it's a beautiful home, and they rent one of the apartments in it now. So they really wanted the house in it. And then there's a huge map back here that you could put some journaling here and a photo or two photos. And again, I just layered my tab, some of the linen or whatever, and a little piece of ribbon. I did fussy cut from the collection this beautiful spray of flowers here and put preserved memories, which came from the kit. But now see, you can see how nice it lays with the spacers in it. Now, if I didn't have the spacers, this would be way down low and this would be popped way up. So I really like that. Now, on this side, they went and took the whole family up to the mountains and he proposed. It says, he asked and she said yes. I thought this was just darling. So I did have a couple pictures of the family. And you can see this was, I think this was early in the year. And you can see a little bit of snow on the hills. And then they're having a toast after he proposed. And it says, a smile costs nothing but gives much. That was also from the paper. And then I loved this. This says, you have bewitched me body and soul. And I love, love, love you. And wish from this day forth never to be parted from you. Well, they've been together since high school, probably 10 years now, but they just now decided to make it official. So I think this is just cool. And I think that was a perfect quote in the paper for them. Now, I left it free on this side and I just did one of these. Have you seen these? It's just a piece of paper that I have coffee dyed and put some staining on. And this is one of the stickers from Your Creative Studio. If you watch that video, this is one of the stickers from that. Isn't that beautiful? It goes perfectly with this paper. But this just unfolds, and it's just a sheet of paper here that she can write all kinds of memories or a list of maybe gifts they got or whatever secret little somethings that she wants to have back here privately. And I left it sticking out so that they would know it was there, but she could slide it completely underneath this. So here's that page. Then we go to this page, and in the paper line, they had these three, and it looked like stacked frames around them. So I went in, and I cut them out, and then I left, see the tape here? I left tape here and tape there, so that when they put their photos in, if they so choose to have the photos permanent, then they can take the backing paper off of the tape, just pull it off and then glue that right down, and then their photos will be there. But that gives them a chance to put what they want. I do have acetate. You can see it shining there in the three spots to protect their photo. And yes, fussy cut. You know I love the fussy cut. But I fussy cut all the flowers out and around and stuck the timeless. And this is another piece from this little clock here. I had it left over and I thought, well, that just kind of ties it in, ties it with the clock over here. So even though this paper line is kind of on the feminine romantic side, it still has enough elements to appeal to the masculine as well. And the colors are so soft. I think they're just going to really like it. So I made a cluster here of stuff and I have this little tag that says love with some scraps that pardon me, I've got the hiccups. The scraps on the back of it. And then here's another tag. And I thought that's the same same quote, only you can see where those pictures were that I just showed you. That was a 12 by 12. This is an 8 by 8 paper. But this is a full sheet. This has all been paper pieced. And then I ran it through with some pressure plates through my Big Shot. I can't think today, my Big Shot. And to make it all these little pieces press in together. And this is another one of those stickers from that Your Creative Studio. I just love the little bit that they added. Oh, and here I wanted to show you. this paper has lines on it, and where it was possible, I left it free so that she could journal on it or put a big picture, whatever she wants. But she has the option to journal on it if she wants. And then this sticks back behind like that. I kind of like the love showing, so I was kind of sticking it in so you kind of saw that. Then I have a pocket on this side. And here we have a little booklet. This is some lace, but it came with this sheer on the edge, and I really like that. I have edged my whole book and a few of the things inside. Again, this is from Claire Charvel at My Creative Spirit. She sells this black tape. Oh my God, I love this tape. Love, love, love it. So that's what I bound my outer edges of my book with, and I bound a couple elements inside. This was one of them, just to join the pages together. And then you flip it up and you have 1, 2, 3. Now again, this has the writing on it, so she could write journal here. I just added a little flower element down here, and I don't think I added anything on the inside. So that's one. Here's another tag. And see, with having a book 8x10 this way, you have a lot of options to have big photo mats, and that's kind of what I wanted. I wanted to have mats that were large enough that they could put 5x7 photos on if they want. On the back of this solid core, this is Basil Smoothie. I just did some stamping here and there on it so it just didn't look so plain. The last tag is humongous. Let's see if I've got my ruler still right here. This one is 7 by 8, so pretty good size. Again, I carried through with that same theme with the linen and a backing and the piece. I love how that looks. And then on this one, I guess I should have, let's see, I guess I used that one. I think I left this, yes, I left it free, so you could tuck something in between back there. Okay, so then these just slide back in the pocket like this. This one. Oh, why are they always so stinky to go back in the way you want them? And then I put this one in like that so that the lace all shows. And then this one like here so that my pull tab shows. So then we have that page. Now we go to the next page. And my thought was she was probably going to want to divide this into sections. The first part being when they were engaged and the first place that they're living like that. Then the next section, she could use this for the shower that she had, or they could put all the elopement and the vows, and then they had a wedding reception, and there's room for that. So on this one, I was kind of thinking, because this was taken at the coast for the wedding, that she could put the coast pictures here, but it's whatever is good for her. I made this pocket, and it's gusseted. See, it's got the gusseted here on the side, and then I put in the tabs. And each one, they all line up on the right-hand side, but each one graduates out by an inch. So it says, remember today, forever timeless, happiness, and precious. And the backs are just plain again. So that gives room for some really large photos, plus this room to tuck a bunch of other photos or memorabilia down in there. On this page, this is when they said their vows, and I love this picture. Because he doesn't have any shoes on in the sand. Isn't that just priceless? Now, like I said, they've been together for years. So they took one of his friends, I believe, and her two sisters, and went to the coast with the minister and got married down there on elopement. And then, like I said, they had their reception back with family and friends. So here again, I took, and there's a little piece of... there's a little piece of ink right in there, but I'm not going to worry about it because when they put the picture in it, you're not going to see it. But I left this open at the top, and again, I left the score tape across here so they can just pull it to seal it shut. But they can slide whatever photo they want in here behind the acetate. And I just love, this is the 12x12 page, and I just love how this looks with the with it cut out for your own picture there. And I like that it's behind the acetate. You know, I say that, and I'm not sure that was a 12 by 12, 8 by 8. It could have been the 12 by 12 paper. I just don't hold me to that. The only thing extra I put on this page was I put a little thing here, and on the together, I put some clear embossing folder. Because somewhere my glossy accents has decided to go live with the paper punch that I've lost eons ago that I cannot find. So my glossy accents is hanging out with it. Someday, if I go and buy the punch and the glossy accents, I'm sure the other two will make an appearance. Okay, so isn't this just gorgeous? So I didn't want to cover up the love. She can put her own picture there and cover it up. So I made this pocket with some more of that really pretty flat lace. And then I made this to go in it. And it holds 6, 12 photos. And I had this washi tape that I had bought eons ago and never used. I think I got it from AliExpress, and it's absolutely gorgeous. It even has the stopwatches. It has the greenery, and I think somewhere in here, yes, it has a little bit of pink. So you would have thought it was made for this collection because it's just perfect. So these were just scraps, offcuts of the paper pages. So I just put them together, inked around the edges, used the washi tape to join them. And then you have room to put, this is two and three quarters inches square, I believe. So you could have a 2.5 inch photo here. But a lot of times, kids, especially young people today, use Instagram and everything so much that I figure a lot of times your photos that you have there are small. So maybe they would want to put a bunch of the little small photos there. And the memories are still around, even though the photo is small. So that's the idea with that one. And then on this side, I did a belly band and a waterfall, and I cut this beautiful flower from the paper, but I left it right here so that the top tab just slides in behind there and under that, and that will hold it in place. Now, instead of wasting the paper to mat each one, I just matted, I think it was 3/4 of an inch on each one, and these measure, I'm not good on centimeters here, guys. These measure just shy of 4 by 6. And they're that way because that's how they fit. But if she has 4 by 6 pictures, she can cut them down just a little and put them on here. So you can see that the inside is plain, but you've got, by the time you put your pictures front and back, it will look just great. Just great. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which is 14, 15, and 16. Room for 16 photos in this little spot. I love waterfalls. Just love them. And then the tab, this part here, you can write on. Can't remember. And I guess you could have a little bit of writing on that one, or just tuck a note in to say what all the photos are. And it just goes right back underneath here. I tried not to use a bunch of magnets in this one and just have it with the natural flips. Now on this page, I have another pocket with the, this is a double cut. And I don't know if you can see, but I have some pop-ups here. So it is very dimensional. This almost looks like a little front of an envelope, I think. And then I have this, which is like a bookmark, but I got to tell you, this is all paper pieced from all little bitty pieces of the paper that I had left. I kept all the little scraps, and when I was sitting downstairs in front of the TV, I glued them all together. You know how I love my scraps. And then I ran it through the embossing folder with the nubbies, just the little dots. And I love it. I think it's really cute. So I've got that one. This is a hidden paper clip in there that goes over the top. Then I have this big mat. Again, this was paper pieced on the front and a solid on the back, but lots of room for journaling. And then we have this great big mat again in the back here like this. And then it flags in here. And it flags in here. I love how that. And I didn't emboss this one because I like the pictures so well. I just kind of left them. And then this one goes in here. And then my love magnet, my love magnet, goes over the top of this one down. It can go anywhere you want it, but that's where I'm going to put it today. So that's that page. And don't you love these water splotches? Oh. Well, the last page, I wanted a big envelope. And I'm not real great at making envelopes this way, so I cheated and I used a yellow, a yellow, just a regular manila envelope as my base. But then when you do that, you got to cover everything up. So I covered the front, but the reason I put this here is I found this gorgeous heart in my stash, and I've had these hearts and hoarded them. I think I have 3 of them, for 10 years at least, I bet. And I thought, this is just silly. What good are they doing hoarding me? So I put an eyelet on the top of the flap of the pocket, and then just the jute cording around like this, and tied it into three spots here so it doesn't come undone. But what I found is that this was really rough here. So, and when I closed my book, it hit right here and scratched the paper off. That's why I have another pop-up, which, you know, out of mistakes come better things. I love this now because it's more dimensional. But I was really worried about this happening again. So what I did, and don't tell anybody, I took an emery board. And I just softly kept filing over the top of this and filed down the rose right here in the middle, some of the little petals. And you can't tell I did it. You'd have no idea, but it's smooth now. And then in here, now this one you can laugh at. We live really close to an Indian casino. And so we get advertisements all the time from them. And a couple days ago, we got one, and it was like this 24-inch long. Well, let's see how long it was. This is 24 inches, because there were 4 of them, and they were folded. And I thought, wow, that's really kind of cool, because I don't have any paper that's 24 inches that I would have to seam it. And this is what I just cut off the bottom of it. That's the only, and I kept it because, and here's how it was. It just came folded on itself this way. And I thought, oh. So I brought it upstairs and I used more of Claire's black tape all the way around the edges. And I also did it between each so you don't have any of, now if you don't have the black tape, all you would have to do is ink around here with something so that you get rid of this stuff, because you're definitely not gonna want any of that to show. And then I just matted it, but now there is room for 8 5x7 photos, and I put the preserved memories on the front again. Love it. And again, I left spots that had the lines for journaling, but this, I thought, man, this is cool. And then when I brought it upstairs, I thought, okay, where am I going to put it in my book? And would you believe it's just the perfect size? Let's see if I don't have to undo that. I'm not going to. Come on. Slide over. There we go. I'll just slide it down. That's easier. It's just the perfect size for, I think I'll move that up there like that. Then it will be easier to pull it out of the book, because I'll have this. It was just the perfect size for my pocket here. Look at here. Oh, I just love it. Now, I did line the whole inside of the pocket. It doesn't go all the way down, because that would be such a waste of paper. So I think it goes like halfway or so. But all you want is the illusion that it is lined. And then this slides inside like this. This comes down and goes around our heart for a closure like that. I think I'll leave it like that. And then, like I said, I ended up doing this so that I would have something popped up a little bit more to offset that. So when it goes, it wouldn't be so much pressure on this heart and possibly go into the paper. So I had this one. And I just tied it like this. And then on the inside, I made it look like a tag, but it actually opens. And on the inside, I just have some of my coffee stain paper. So it could be a secret note or a poem or music or anything that they like. And then I just simply put my twine through and ran it through the loop. I know you all do that, but just in case. And I'll tie it in a bow again. And then it just slips right down underneath there. So what do you think? She didn't want a whole lot of pages, and we ended up with 4 pages plus inside, front, and back cover. 4 pages. But I have a couple more. I could add more to it. And that's the beauty of this kind of a book, is all you have to do is untie it and then add some more pages to it and tie it back up again. So it's just, on the back is just plain like this with that gorgeous clock on it. Don't like to put anything on the back because you know yourself it gets bunged up. But I love the black facing around all the way around. So there's my wedding album. And it's so fun when it's people I know. This is like, you know how you have relatives that are relatives by blood? These are my relatives by friendship. They have been a part of, her grandma and grandpa are like my brother and sister. They're very, very close to me. So I just, this was fun. So anyway, everybody, thank you for joining me today. If you're not a subscriber, I hope you subscribe, hit the like button, share it with a friend, and most importantly, have a great crafty day. Bye, everybody.